And we bring in former 2019, 2020 Missouri Gatorade Player of the Year and state runner-up in football in Class 6, running back Isaiah Davis. How are you, sir?
Doing good, man. I'm blessed.
It's awesome to hear. And I mean, before we get to the good stuff, I mean, we got to talk about the other good stuff. I'd like to kind of talk about what's happened since you've left Joplin, and our viewers and listeners at home here. I mean, you've racked up 3,655 plus yards in almost 4 years there. You got a few more games left until it's officially the 4-year mark. It's crazy that you've been gone that long. Feels like just yesterday that you were here running for Joplin. 1,400 of those yards coming last year, 685 this year currently. 4 games to go, though. That's insane. Congrats on a successful time out there. And yeah, can you kind of describe your journey and how it's gone at South Dakota State?
And definitely like a wonderful journey. You know, I've been blessed to be part of an organization like STSU. You know, coming out of high school, I still have my coaches, my senior speech and the players. You know, all I wanted coming out of high school was an opportunity in which STSU gave me. You know, definitely been probably the best decision of my life so far. You know, coming here, the relationships I made with the players, the coaches, we truly are a family here. And, you know, I'm blessed to say that. The culture here is like no other. You have guys leaving, transferring, and guys who transfer here and talk about how it's different here. But I've been blessed. I definitely carry like the family aspect of we had a Joplin, you know, through here. You know, I try to bring as much people as I can from Joplin here, whether it be fans, you know, getting Quinn up here, you know, other recruits. So you know, I'm trying to just do my part and, you know, open it up for other players too and get them. I'm seeing Southeast Missouri because, you know, SEMO doesn't get. Southwest Missouri doesn't get looked at as far as recruiting because, you know, we have Kansas City and St. Louis. So,
yeah,
I do my part.
True. And I mean, so you've also dealt a little bit with the injury bug over there in the last couple of seasons. How have you been able to overcome that and be successful as you've been?
I think it's just having good mental health, you know, doing everything I can, dealing with injuries. We have a great training staff here with Charlie and Alley, and so you know, attacking of injuries in the training room, just like you would a workout. It's kind of like the mindset you have to have, and you know, always staying positive. You know, sometimes it gets hard, especially when I had my shoulder injury, me being out for 9 weeks. You know, I never had an injury like that in football before, so my mental was definitely rough. But you know, I had a great group of guys to lean on. You know, when times got hard, you know, they were always there for me, cracking jokes, trying to up my spirit up. So you know, when we're an organization like this, where you know, guys just really like a family. You know, it's easy to overcome adversity like that.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, another question here I have for you is, out of all of that, which game made you more nervous, the Missouri State Championship game or the national title game?
Honestly, I would say the state championship game.
Okay.
I feel like, you know, last year when we were rolling, I feel like, you know, if we play like this, you know, ain't no one messing with us in the country. We were rolling on all cylinders. Offense was rolling. Got the playoffs averaging like 40-something points. We're beating everybody by 20-something points. We had beat NDSU previously before. We knew what we had to do to handle business. And we were rolling. You know, nothing could stop us. If we something could stop us, it was us. But even at that point, I didn't think, you know, that was possible. But in the state championship, too, we were the big underdog. You know, going to that week, I remember people talking about how we had no chance because, you know, they were ranked like 13th, 12th in the country at the time. So, you know, we were going there to prove a point. You know, we were up 20-14 at half, and we were up 26, but they had got the touchdown right before half. So, you know, definitely we're taking care of business there, but then we came out second half with like 3 or 4 turnovers. So, you know, they let them get back in the game. We ended up losing 35-20. So,
yeah, crazy game that was too. But we bring that up, national championship too. How does it feel to be a national champion, and what does it mean for you?
You know, it's awesome. You know, definitely, you know, one of the goals of I think everybody who plays called football growing up is, you know, to win a national champion and the national championship. But you know, in high school, we got to the championship spot. You know, we didn't finish it out, but you know, in college, got the opportunity to go back and did it again. Yeah. But you know, definitely. A wonderful experience, you know, something I'll never take for granted. Memories from that day, you know, that I have, I'll hold forever. You know, but kind of going, like, thinking about it, like, So winning the championship, you know, obviously, like the feeling that day was like no other.
Yeah.
But, you know, I woke up the next morning and, you know, it was just another day. Kind of like made me like realize like it's more than just winning the championship. You know, I have bigger goals, you know, just winning the national championship. You know, I want to do more in my future, like going down the line, whether it be NFL or making a difference in other people's life. Because that satisfaction, it wasn't very long. But, you know, I'm definitely blessed. You know, like I said before, it's like no other feeling. Like I felt invincible for the 30 minutes I was on the podium with the blue and yellow falling from the sky. But you know, definitely want a full experience.
7-0 at this point. Is the goal still to get back and win another title, new coach and everything too? I mean, or is it just a game-by-game basis at this point?
Just a game-by-game basis. We got to take care of business, you know, each and every week. We know the importance of, you know, being at home, having a home field advantage during the playoffs. So, you know, our focus right now is USD. We know it's going to be a tough game, rivalry game. So, you know, our bigger emphasis is just living in the now. Because if we live in the future, we're gonna forget everything that's now. We're not going to be focused. Our mind's somewhere else. So we're going to have tunnel vision each and every week. You know, block out the outside noise and just, you know, focus on the task at hand.
Awesome. And next, I mean, you kind of mentioned NFL stride there. I mean, we'd like to ask, if we may, is there any intention to head that direction? And if so, has there been any interest from any teams thus far?
So definitely always, you know, always been a dream of mine ever since I was a little kid playing NFL. I used to grow up in JYFA, 3rd through 6, watching Barry Sanders highlights, the same video over and over again. But, you know, I definitely want to make that step. You know, when that time comes, it'll come. Something I'm excited for. You know, I think I prepared myself for that step. But, you know, I don't know where these next couple of months is going to have for me, where I'm going to end up, you know, what's going to happen. So, like I said before, I'm just taking it step by step. I think my mindset is, if I just live in the now, do everything right now to prepare myself for pro, you know, when that step comes, I'll be more prepared for it, and, you know, just be another step in life. But so yeah, I'm excited for it.
Awesome. All right, final question here. And it's kind of one of those ones that's like, oh man, it finally happened. And that is, last week you got to play your former teammate in Zach Westmoreland. First off, what did that mean for you to catch up with him? And second, was there any trash talk, jabs, or any of that stuff going into the week?
It was definitely cool. You know, playing Zach, it's something that growing up we never thought about. But, you know, going to high school, when he had looked at going to SIU the first time and I was going to SJSU, we definitely thought about, you know, that time when it would happen to be playing him. Definitely wonderful experience. You know, going to warm up, we got out there a little late, but I was looking for him, and I seen he texted me. He's like, "Where you at?" So I'm looking for him. I see him. I go up to him, but you know, it's all love though. You know, me and Zach always have that competitive nature in us. You know, it's always fun going up against him. You know, I didn't have the chance to, you know, hit him or he hit me. So that was never something I was, you know, wanting to happen. You know, because, you know, competitive nature. You know, we were trash talking mode, but it's all love at the end of the day. It's all. We're all competitive guys who just want to win. But this experience of seeing his family there, my family there, us just, you know, bond in. You know, it's bigger than football, and we truly have a family.
Indeed. And, we appreciate the time out of your week. Good luck this weekend, and good luck for the rest of your career, and hopefully everything works out. We're looking forward to it.
I appreciate it. Have a good one.
You too.
Yeah.